हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द कोर्स ऑफ ऑटोमोटिव मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेसेस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। माय सेल्फ विमल सलोत फ्रॉम एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द आर्क वेल्डिंग। सो चैप्टर इज वेल्डिंग एंड टॉपिक इज आर्क वेल्डिंग। नाउ देर आर सम टाइप्स ऑफ आर्क वेल्डिंग। दिस टाइप्स आर शील्डेड मेटल आर्क वेल्डिंग, सबमर्ज्ड आर्क वेल्डिंग, टीग वेल्डिंग दैट इज टंगस्टन इनर्ट गैस वेल्डिंग, मिग वेल्डिंग दैट इज मेटल इनर्ट गैस वेल्डिंग एंड प्लाज्मा आर्क वेल्डिंग। अमोंग दिस टाइप्स इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस टू टाइप्स दैट इज शील्डेड मेटल आर्क वेल्डिंग एंड सबमर्ज्ड आर्क वेल्डिंग। नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ शील्डेड मेटल आर्क वेल्डिंग। वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट प्रिंसिपल equipments, its operation, advantages, disadvantages and application of this welding technique. In this diagram, principle of this process is shown. The equipments which are used for this process are power source, it may be AC or DC power source, electrode holder and electrode with flux coating. Formerly the electrode were used without coating also, they were known as bare electrode, but nowadays commonly used electrode are provided with flux coating. So here this setup is shown. Electrode and this workpiece both are connected to the power supply. About polarity, electrode is connected to the positive supply and workpiece is connected to the negative supply. Or reverse polarity may also be used. Depending on the requirement, polarity may be selected. If fast deposition rate of electrode is required, then electrode is connected with negative supply, and if faster rate molten metal is required, then it is connected, workpiece is connected to the negative polarity. So depending on the requirement, the polarity may be adjusted. Now this electrode consists of a coating which is known as a flux coating, and flux is generally made up of lime, silica or oxides. So when this flux is melt, it is providing one protective gas layer, because when the process takes place, the metal which is at higher temperature comes in contact with the oxygen of environment, so it may be result in formation of metal oxide. So to prevent the formation of that oxide, here protective gas layer is used and it is provided by the help of the flux coating. So when this electrode and workpiece are set with polarity, now it is necessary to initiate the arc, just to initiate the welding process. So for that, the electrode has to come in contact with the workpiece by a moment, and by that way the arc is initiated. When arc is initiated, there will be sufficient temperature to melt the base metal. So now this arc takes place between the electrode and workpiece, and the base metal will be melted. When this coating is melted, it is providing this type of protective layer. It is a protective gas layer, so it is helpful to prevent the contamination of the base metal and welding pool by the surrounding oxygen of the environment, and it is also resulting in a slag layer. So this slag layer is necessary to remove after the completion of the welding process. So advantages of this process is it is almost simplest of all arc welding process. Equipment is portable, comparatively it is less expensive, and various metal and disadvantages of this process are its mechanization is difficult because of limited length of the electrode. Comparatively it is slower process. Because of flux coating, chances of slag entrapment and other related defects are there, and welding control is difficult. Applications of this welding processes are, it may be used for metals and their alloys, for boilers and pressure vessel fabrication, in automotive and aircraft industries, for shipbuilding and bridge construction. Next type of welding process is submerged arc welding. We will discuss about its principle, equipments, operation, advantages, disadvantages, and application. Now, in case of submerged arc welding, the arc remains always under the protective layer of a flux. So, it is different than shielded metal arc welding. Here, in this case, the arc is always under the blanket of a flux. The equipments which are used are flux hopper, electrode wire, feed rolls, drive motor, servo motor to control the feed of the electrode wire, and DC power source. So here the function of this flux hopper is to store the flux and to provide the flux as per the requirement. So deposition rate of the flux is controlled by this flux hopper. Here, consumable electrode is used and it is continuously fed with the help of this drive rolls, which is rotated with the help of the drive motor. So it is a consumable electrode and continuously it is fed throughout the welding process. The feed of this electrode can be controlled with the help of servo control device. Power source is also used as shown here. So when welding process starts, initially flux is provided by this flux hopper. So before starting the welding process, flux is to be deposited at the welding pool. So flux is deposited at the welding zone, and when arc is initiated, it will be sufficient high temperature to melt the flux which is coming through this flux hopper. And the material of this flux is generally silica, lime, or it may be oxide of the metal. So when this melt, it provides a protective layer. So always this arc will be under the layer or under the blanket of the flux. Always it is a process which is controlled by these feed rolls. So it is actually, we can consider it as automatic process which is being done. Now, advantages of this process are, due to high heat concentration, considerably its speed is high as compared to other processes. Weld distortion is very less. Very neat appearance of the welding zone can be obtained, and smooth weld shape is also obtained. No edge preparation is required, as it is required in case of burnt welding. Minimum welding fume or arc light is emitted. Arc is always under the cover of a blanket of the flux, so there is no chance of spatter of the weld. And 50 to 90% of the flux is recoverable, recycled, and it can be reused. Disadvantages of this process are, it is limited to ferrous and some nickel based alloys. Normally it is limited to long straight seam or rotated pipes or vessels. It requires relatively troublesome flux handling system. Flux and slag residue can present health and safety concern. It always requires, in between or after the completion of the process, it is required to remove this slag at periodic time. Application of this process: it is used for fabrication of pressure vessels or boilers, for pipes, penstocks, locomotives, ship building, and in nuclear power industries. Thank you very much for watching.